This footage captures the 1996 Chinese-launched Intelsat 708 telecommunications satellite departing from the Xichang Satellite Launch Center to disastrous results. Shortly after liftoff, the rocket malfunctioned and was sent flying nearly horizontal, just barely above the Earth. Although the exact crash site was covered up, it is thought that the rocket traveled anywhere from 1 to 1.5 miles, or 1.5 to 2 kilometers, before crashing into a hill in a nearby town. Origin. NASA decided to ban commercial payloads from its space shuttle program due to the 1986 Space Shuttle Challenger disaster when Challenger broke down 73 seconds after liftoff. This left American satellite operators in search of space launch options in Europe or Asia. The Chinese government was seeking to be competitive in space, so it offered to take Intelsat's 708 satellite on the untested Long March 3B rocket. The price of only $56 million was half that of the European Ariane launch price tag. Californian company Space Systems / Laurel received permission from the US Department of State to launch the Intelsat satellites in collaboration with the Chinese. The components for the satellites, however, had to be transported in stages to comply with ITAR restrictions, so the Commerce Department took from 1992 to 1996 to finish transferring them. Engineers sent from the United States reportedly found the infrastructure of the Chinese Space Center to be just sufficient, but a tad primitive. Intelsat placed all of its Western employees and contractors in a renovated hotel with Americanized conditions. Some were worried by the experiences they had at Xichang preceding the launch. Several engineers suspected they were being spied on by the Chinese, particularly after a tennis court net materialized just minutes after it was pointed out that the net was missing. None of the Chinese staff had been present for the conversation. Furthermore, the Western team felt the Chinese safety protocols and attitudes were too relaxed. In fact, reports circulated that the launch pad intended for the Intelsat 708 had undergone repairs after an accidental ignition in an enclosed room during an earlier test for a solid fuel rocket motor. The launch was scheduled for 2:50 a.m. on February the 15th. On that morning, all the hotel staff and guests were summoned to the Satellite Preparation Building by Space Systems / Laurel. The building, to the south of the planned flight path and protected from the launch pad by mountains, was packed with Westerners and Chinese locals alike. Many staff members asked for permission to go home and rest instead of attending the launch, but those requests were denied. Launch. On February 15, 1996, the 426-ton Long March 3B rocket flew for only 22 seconds in the direction of the village before crashing into it. The overstressed payload broke off from the rocket and flew to the ground as it flew. The explosion burned most of the components and allegedly took some of the villagers. The American engineers involved repeatedly claimed that as they were transported to the satellite processing building, they witnessed villagers approaching the area of the crash. Bruce Campbell, an engineer involved in the project, told a Natalie Zack of Aerospace Magazine that, quote, "It was a party atmosphere. There were many dozens, if not hundreds, of people there." The Chinese government, on the other hand, claimed that most of the villagers had been evacuated before the launch. Immediately after the start, there was widespread panic among the staff that toxic fumes originating from the oxidizer and fuel could enter the building. All air conditioning and airflow mechanisms were shut down, and people were crammed into the fueling facility, the most isolated part of the building. Everyone was also given gas masks and protective equipment. The initial panic was calmed down when detectors did not pick up any signs of toxins as the wind was blowing them away. They communicated with the employees at the Mission Control Center, who were also safe. The footage was analyzed in the United States by experts almost immediately as the event was being televised. Observers saw that the nozzles of the rocket had been wildly swiveling as it tried to correct its course before crashing. One of the team members who had been standing on the roof of a building actually recorded the accident. He fell when the blast wave hit, but was not thrown off the roof. The extent and details of the accident's consequences have been hotly debated by witnesses and analysts. The government, through the Xinhua News Agency, or New China News Agency, reported that 6 people were missing after the accident, while 57 were injured. Yet American media estimated that around 200 to 500 people should have been impacted by the crash. Witness reports contradicted the numbers released by the Chinese. Once the area was safe to explore, eyewitnesses claimed that all the village buildings were either structurally damaged beyond repair or flat out gone. At the same time, dozens of ambulances were spotted in the area, as well as several covered flatbed trucks. Aftermath. Official reports stated that the rocket had been completely destroyed, but the satellite was allegedly intact and shipped back to the United States. Campbell told Aerospace Magazine, quote, "We were there with the Chinese going over a routine of this is ours, this is yours. It was surprising how much of it survived. The propellant tanks were intact, liquid apogee motor, solar panels, much of the structure." He also believed that the reported death toll was incorrect. The village no longer exists, and the Space Review later found that the village population was less than 1,000. They were also routinely evacuated before events, seemingly giving some credibility to the government's claim of a limited impact. As for what caused the crash, an investigation conducted by the Chinese resulted in a report claiming the inertial measurement unit had malfunctioned. On the other hand, the companies in charge of the satellite insurance conducted its own review, identifying a different set of issues that the Chinese adopted into their official account. The findings were used to improve the rockets from the Long March set. Space System/Laurel also managed to recover essential components of their equipment, including sensitive communications and encryption technology that could have been dangerous if it fell into the wrong hands.